Dad, on our YouTube channel, we got a question that I did not feel comfortable answering on my own, but I did think that it was interesting. So it was on the video that we made about reasons why a furnace might leak water. And somebody asked a question on it, could your furnace be leaking water due to a crack in the heat exchanger? So I'd rather an actual professional answer
and
that question.
Initially you said, no, that doesn't make sense.
Initially I'm like, well, that sounds ridiculous. Why would that make sense? And Dad's like, actually.
Yeah, it could.
Which is why I should not be answering these questions myself. So let me turn it over to you and you can answer that question.
Yes, it can be the sign of a failed heat exchanger, but not every furnace has moisture inside the heat exchanger. But a high efficiency, what we call a condensing furnace, does have a secondary heat exchanger that is condensing moisture. So that's where the moisture that you see running to the floor drain on some furnaces is gathered. And so yes, you can have a failure in the secondary heat exchanger of a condensing furnace and it will leak water. You know, it'll actually drip water. So yes, that's a clear sign of a problem if in the winter time we're coming servicing a furnace and we open up the blower compartment and there's water. That's a serious thing we need to investigate.
It's a sign that there might be a crack in the heat exchanger or
right.
a failure.
Yeah, exactly. You know, now granted, water could also come from a humidifier or, you know, typically you don't have water in a drain pan, you know, like for an air conditioner drain pan, but you certainly have water from a humidifier. And so it doesn't necessarily mean that, oh, it's you have a failed heat exchanger, but it is definitely is something that you need to investigate because it can be the sign of a failed heat exchanger.
Okay, that there's some water in the furnace cabinet.
Yeah,
interesting.
Right.
Interesting.
Yep.
Okay, did not know. Thank you.
Very good.